want you all to remember your earliest and most vivid memories. Remember your first birthday party, the way your grandma's house smelled, the taste of your mother's special dish, and if you're anything like me, your parents scolding after failing your first exam. Now imagine letting go of those very memories you hold so dear. Imagine forgetting your way of life, the ones you've loved, cared for, and the memories you hold with them. Imagine not knowing how to do things you've done for your entire life, like how to start a car or throw out the trash. These grim collection of behaviors are unfortunately just a small part of everyday reality for those affected by Alzheimer's. So what really is Alzheimer's, right? Alzheimer's is this complex mix of cognitive and neurological symptoms that cause brain deterioration overall, resulting in death. And just to provide some context here, here is a patient whose brain was plagued with Alzheimer's next to a healthy, normally aged brain. So with over 50 million people globally suffering from the disease, and actually 4.1 million in India alone, there still is no cure. It's in part due to the fact that after billions of dollars and decades of research, we still don't know what exactly caused the disease. We know that clinical signs usually show up after age 65, but changes in the brain may begin years, or in some cases, decades in advance. This makes diagnosis extremely difficult. Patients are funneled through this complicated and convoluted pathway for detection, which can sometimes take years and cost thousands of dollars. Imagine having to go through brain imaging scans, cognitive assessments, and in rare cases, even having your spine punctured to confirm a diagnosis. These modalities are expensive. They require specialized training, and they're resource intensive. But most importantly, they always happen after symptoms are shown, making this overall hurdle to get a diagnosis extremely high. And this is one of the problems with the way we look at the disease, right? Because the barrier to obtain a diagnosis is so high, we only start testing for the disease after symptoms are shown. And so looking at this current ecosystem for AD detection, my team and I quickly became part of a growing movement, frustrated and fed up by the current state of diagnostics in Alzheimer's. We knew that a profound change was needed to shift the focus from a cause and effect paradigm to one that was more preventative in nature and could detect signs earlier on. We knew that such a device would have to be made that was, one, cost affordable enough to be scalable, two, could provide quantitative data, and three, be used to make Alzheimer's screenings more routine. My team and I have worked with hundreds of patients and doctors to create a system that can diagnose the disease more accurately and cost-effectively than any other modality. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the NeuroRevolution. The human brain is the most complex organ in the body. With over a billion neurons, it's as dense and networked as our very own Milky Way galaxy. And each one of these neurons fires complex electrical signals more than 200 times per second. And we can record them using something called an EEG, or an electroencephalogram, or a brainwave scanner. Now, they can come in various shapes and sizes, but here's an easy-to-use and portable one that we've been working with here. You'll notice that there are several electrodes, or sensors, placed on different parts of the brain. And each one of these sensors can record brainwave activity from that region. Now, we can take in large amounts of electrical data collected by sensors like these and combine it with the power of machine learning and big data to have a glimpse into the finer workings of the Alzheimer's brain. Patient testing is as simple as someone over the age of 65 coming in, taking this 15-minute brainwave scanning test and the algorithms run and analyzed, and the results provided to the physician instantly. We can look at billions and billions of data points to create hundreds of analytical understandings that we would have never been able to do before. I was fascinated to see how we could provide new understanding to things like how complex a signal looks from a certain part of the brain or how fast a stimulus is responding to a certain brain region. But of course, the question becomes, why try to make Alzheimer's diagnosis earlier, especially if there's no cure for the disease? Well, think about this. Imagine if you were diagnosed with a disease maybe years before onset. You'd have a lot more time to plan financially and legally, and we can also start you on drugs that can potentially slow the progression of the disease. If we can slow the progression of the disease enough, you would never require enhanced life support, thus making ridiculously high cost of care a thing of the past. Also, as someone who's diagnosed in later stages of Alzheimer's, you're not always eligible for a lot of novel treatment options. And so by getting you this diagnosis earlier, we can open the door for you to enter into these new clinical trials for new drugs, thus giving some hope for you and your family, while at the same time bringing the rest of the world closer to a cure. The future of healthcare innovation lies in DIY science, and our results are a perfect example of this. Imagine one day going to the doctor's office, taking this 15-minute brainwave scanning test, and being told you do or don't have early signs of dementia. We'll check again in 6 months. Imagine a world in which transformations in digital health and technologies like these can tell you which symptoms you'll develop before you even know about them. As we move into the future, we're going to be living in this data noisy, complicated, and challenging environment. In the emergence of new consumer-grade brainwave scanning technologies like these, only enable hackers and hobbyists like us to democratize the brain like never before. To solve the most pressing issues in medicine, like Alzheimer's, cancer, or HIV, it's up to us to find meaning and order in a world of chaotic disorder. The tools to create change and transform the lives of patients are becoming increasingly available to the public. And so the question becomes, how will you make a difference? Thank you.